everyone. So today I'm making dinner for tonight, and I'm using leftover London broil, and I want to kind of mix it up and put it into a new dish. So my favorite way to do that is making an egg roll. Today I'm making kind of like a southwestern burrito egg roll. I'm using this little piece of London broil. Use as much or as little as you want, totally your call. I'm using spring roll wrappers, and I'm going to be using a little bit of brown rice that I've just cooked up already and seasoned with a little bit of chili powder and some salt, some black beans for that Mexican flavor, some sprouts, because sprouts are just very healthy. I love to sneak them in whenever possible, and of course, the meat. And you could use chicken, you could use meat. It's the perfect way to get everything into a perfect little package. I'm just going to take my little piece of meat here, and you want to either shred it or cut it up into small pieces. And I like to leave my meat a little bit underdone, so that way when I cook it some more, it doesn't get overcooked. It stays perfectly tender. All right, so I'm gonna cut this into little cubes. These need to fit nicely into our, I think that should be enough. I'm gonna put my meat over here onto the side and I'll show you how we assemble this. Really simple. Take anything you have in your fridge, be creative and throw it in. Take a little egg roll wrapper, put it on a diagonal like this, and then you're just gonna start filling. I'm gonna take a little bit of my meat, a little bit of the beans, a little bit of my rice, right on in there, put it right in the center. Now, I'm gonna mix together some barbecue sauce with chili sauce. So now we're throwing in a little bit of American style here. We're mashing it all up. Mix it all up. Kind of just amping up your own barbecue sauce here. Taking store-bought, making it your own. Pour a little bit right in here. Top it with some sprouts, which are so healthy. So pretty. What a shame we have to wrap the whole thing up, huh? You take your egg. Just wet your fingers with a little bit of egg and make sure you get a nice tight seal, okay? Take this bottom corner, wrap it around and under all the vegetables and meat, tuck it in tight, roll over one side, bring over the other side, just like an envelope. Look exactly like an envelope. And then you just roll it up the rest of the way, pushing everything in as you go. Make a tight, perfect little egg roll. If you need a little extra egg here, feel free to use it. You don't want these to open up. You could deep fry these, you just have to really make sure that they're sealed tight. I like to keep it a little bit lighter, and I'm just gonna bake them on a baking sheet. Spray them with a little bit of cooking spray. That's what helps them crisp up, get golden brown. Throw them into a 400 degree oven for about maybe 25, 35 minutes. Everything's already cooked inside, so all you're doing is just getting that nice, crispy exterior and blending all the flavors together. That's it. I'm gonna keep rolling my egg rolls. I'll stick them in the oven, and I'll show you what they look like when they come out. Out of the oven, they were cooking at 400 degrees for about 25, 35 minutes. They're golden brown, that's how you know they're done. They're crispy, amazing. You would never know that they're not deep fried. You can feel good about eating these egg rolls. And I'll show you how I like to plate them up. All right, so I'm just gonna take two little egg rolls. I like to serve it with guacamole because we're doing kind of like a Mexican-y flair. Yum. And to make it look extra gorgeous, we just top it with some sprouts. Now, tell me you're not gonna make this for dinner. This is an impressive dish. Go make it, enjoy, and always keep it fresh.